The inaugural season of the Overwatch League was historic in many ways. Many fans remember it as the season that the Shanghai Dragons finished the year with a 0-40 record. Due to the dismal result, after the season, a majority of the roster departed from the team, looking for a fresh start and a chance at redemption. But for tank player Yui Seok Lee, better known as Fearless, his redemption arc would take him out of the fire and right back into the Dragon's Den. Fearless originally joined the Dragons for Stage 2 of the inaugural season. After a winless start in Stage 1, the Dragons announced that they would be signing 4 players, one of whom was Fearless, who had found success with Element Mystic in Korea, and was instrumental in his team qualifying for Apex Challengers Season 5. As a result, upon joining the Dragons roster, many were expecting Fearless to play a large role in leading the team to winning their first game, and hopefully more than one. Unfortunately, due to visa issues, fans would only see Fearless and fellow new addition Ado in the final week of Stage 2. While both players would prove to be clear upgrades to the roster, it wasn't enough, as the Dragons finished the stage with another 0-10 record. Shanghai looked much more competitive through Stages 3 and 4, but unfortunately, could never capture that elusive win. Despite the losses, Fearless continued to impress fans and analysts alike with his amazing Winston play.
Another mech there. Luma is still alive, and the members of the Outlaws are coming back. Wolbat's still there. Primal Rage for Fearless. Fearless, though, turning this around.
Oh, yeah, man. He has been doing great on the Winston already. There goes Coolmat. Taken out eventually. They put a lot into it, and they will take...
While most matches were still 0-4 or 1-3 losses for the Dragons, they were able to come close to getting that first win with a 2-3 loss to the Philadelphia Fusion in the 4th week of Stage 3 and another 2-3 loss to the Florida Mayhem in the 4th week of Stage 4. But unfortunately, an L is an L. And although Fearless and the rest of the Dragons put forth their best efforts, the team would end the season 0-40, marking the worst single season record not just in professional esports history, but possibly the worst season in professional sports ever. With a new strong Korean core building up the roster for the second season, featuring the likes of DPS players Ding and Diem, it would appear that Fearless may finally be able to find some success in the Overwatch League. Unfortunately, a nagging health issue would have different plans as the Dragons announced that the team would start the second season without Fearless, as he would be returning home to Korea to focus on recovery. With no word on when Fearless would return, the Dragons were quick to find a solution, bringing on Gamsu from the Boston Uprising just 4 days after Fearless's departure to take his place. While Fearless was gone at the start of Season 2, the Dragons began to see improvement, even picking up their first win in Week 2 with Gamsu beating his old team, the Boston Uprising.
They're pushing from the back, they're taken up again, Nope's gonna be hacked, he's gonna be taken out of the mech, finished off!
It's happening!
This could be it, the second ticks, getting ready to come through! Kellex gonna be eliminated! Transcendence is out from Aim God, but it's gonna expire, they will be able to finish him off!
There you go!
They're gonna get it, just a couple more percent to go! Let them have it, Boston! Axiom, pop of the Primal Rage, but it does not matter! Ladies and gentlemen, history has been made! The Shanghai Dragons!
With Gamsu proving to be an important member of the roster, it was clear that if Fearless would return, he may have to sit on the bench with little to no playtime. As a result, 62 days after the original announcement of his break, the Dragons announced that Fearless would be transferred to Team CC, the academy team for the Dragons in Contenders China. This move was intended to allow Fearless to take all the time he needed to recover while working towards returning to form. Upon joining Team CC, Fearless found success, making it into the quarterfinals of the first season of Contenders China 2019, where they would ultimately be eliminated by Bilibili Gaming. However, this wasn't good enough, as Fearless and the rest of Team CC would come back stronger in the second season, finishing the regular season at the top of their group with a 4-1 record, with their one loss coming at the hands of LGE Huya. In the playoffs, the team made it to the finals, but unfortunately, LGE Huya would once again defeat Fearless and the rest of Team CC.
As well, and all of the hopes and dreams of Team CC will fall with those picks and another whole hog for Sven. Your Chinese contender, Season 2 champions in 2019, will go the way of Ling An Esports and Huyen.
That second place finish would prove to be the highlight of 2019 for Fearless, as Team CC went on to make early exits at the rest of the tournaments that year. While 2019 was a bit of a disappointment for Fearless, it was clear that his play was beginning to pick up again. And coming into 2020, he was determined to make a mark. Having recovered from his health issues and seeing his play rapidly improving, Team CC would go on to take first at both the Contenders China Seeding Tournament and the Huya Super League. This would be the last amateur tournament for Fearless, as he was called up to rejoin the Dragons not long after. While fans were excited to see their favorite tank return, the world had other plans, as the COVID-19 pandemic caused the cancellation of all homesteads hosted in China. It wouldn't be until week 8 that Fearless finally saw some playtime, and unfortunately, his contribution was dropping map 1 to the Chengdu Hunters en route to a 0-3 loss for the Dragons. But 3 weeks later, in a rematch against the Hunters, Fearless would finally achieve something that was 3 seasons in the making. With his signature Winston, Fearless and the rest of the Shanghai Dragons went on to defeat the Chengdu Hunters 3-0, avenging their previous loss and earning Fearless his first tick in the Overwatch League win column. From then on, the Dragons went on a tear, losing only one game in a close series against the Seoul Dynasty. After that, they ran through everyone. Throughout these wins, Fearless saw limited playtime, as he would only slot into the roster for 3 series. But when he was on the main stage, his Reinhardt and Winston were impossible to ignore.
Already, Shanghai Dragons are just rolling it forward. They have come prepared, they've done their homework, they've drank their milk, Josh.
However, his time to shine would be at the May Melee Asia Grand Finals. After making quick work of the London Spitfire and New York Excelsior, the Dragons were set to play against the Seoul Dynasty in the finals. Starting on the bench, Fearless watched helplessly as his team lost the first 3 maps, going down 0-3 in the series.
There is no more room for error for the Shanghai Dragons. They are down 0-3 in a 1-4 series. So it's not over, but they're going to have to do the unthinkable and reverse sweep the 7th-seeded Seoul Dynasty here if they want to win in the May Monthly Melee.
With nothing left to lose, Fearless was put on for the 4th map and, seizing the opportunity, proceeded to put on a show.
Executing him as he was below half HP. Self-destruct comes in as well as Marvel will find that one kill. Overtime will be burning here. Fearless using his Primal Rage. He does get the kill onto Matosa. I'm going to clutch this one. Marvel goes down. He sent in his own bomb. And whilst he was doing it, he was vulnerable. He was afraid. He was alone. And he will fall. I cannot believe what we are witnessing right now. Just the overtime has burned and it is...
With near-perfect Winston play and amazing use of Primal Rage, Fearless rose to the occasion, fighting back against the Dynasty and leading his team to achieve the impossible, a reverse sweep.
But this is still turnable for the Seoul Dynasty.
Still turnable, and that's going to force out Primal Rage from Fearless. He's got to come up big with this. He's got to come up clutch. He's battering them away. 2 kills for him, forcing the positioning. Moving up to the Torbjorn, but he was not able to get his ultimate off in time. The blade, or not the blade, I should say the beam. It burns them down. It burns them down indeed, Josh. The overtime, is it not enough? It is not enough whatsoever. The Shanghai Dragons have done it. I cannot believe what we have witnessed. The reverse sweep.
After being unable to meet the expectations of carrying a failing team, to struggling with health issues and being demoted to contenders, to fighting his way up to the top with Team CC and reclaiming his place in the Overwatch League, Fearless has finally found the success that he's been looking for. Now considered one of the best tank players in the world, the question is how far can Fearless and the Shanghai Dragons really go? Will they be Season 3 champions? With Fearless leading the way, anything is possible. Thanks for watching this video, guys. We hope you learned a lot about Fearless and the Shanghai Dragons. It's been a tough couple of months with quarantine and everything happening in the world, but we here at Action really appreciate you guys sticking with us and continuing to watch our videos. If you have any suggestions for what you want to see or games you want covered, let us know in the comments below. My name's Jonah. Thanks for watching.